In this numerical problem, we have to basically show that a vector field function is solenoidal. So the question is that the vector field, which is defined by this way, f is equal to x plus 3y I plus y minus 3z j plus x minus 2z in vector k, is solenoidal. Here the function is defined in terms of unit vector, so the field will be a vector field. So I have applied the condition of divergence, which basically defined that a vector field function will be solenoidal. So the condition is that divergence of this field should be equal to 0. So this vector field function will be solenoidal if this satisfy this particular condition, that del dot f divergence of f is equal to 0. So now I have to put the value of del operator left hand side, that is iota del upon del x plus g del upon del y plus k del upon del z, and this dot product symbol for the scalar product, and the value of vector f, that is x plus 3y I plus y minus 3z j plus x minus 2z k. So now, as we know that the expansion of the scalar product, so I have to take the scalar product between these two terms with I. So I dot I is equal to 1, I dot j is equal to 0, and similarly with k, that will also 0. So the only first term will survive. The result will be del upon del x, and this term, that is x plus 3y. Now expansion with respect to j, the product j dot I will be equal to 0, j dot j will be equal to 1, and j dot k will be 0. So the result only because of these two terms. So del upon del y, y minus 3j plus k dot I 0, k dot j 0, k dot k is equal to 1. So result is del upon del j, and that x minus 2j. So now the point is only of differentiation. So now we have to differentiate these function basically with respect to x, y and z. So the first term is differentiation with respect to x, and this is the variable only, so the result will be equal to 1. And for this, this is y, and we are differentiating with respect to x, so result will be 0. Plus, now the differentiation with respect to y, the result is equal to 1. This is z, so result will be 0. And here again, this is minus 2z. We are differentiating the term with respect to z, so result will be minus 2. And as a result, we found this 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. So the divergence of this field is equal to 0. So it means this vector field function satisfies the condition. It means this vector field function will be solenoidal. Now by this way, one can solve the numerical problems related to the divergence, whether that is simply calculation of the divergence or it satisfies the condition where the result is equal to 0. So there are only two problems related to the divergence, where one have to put the value direct and find out the result, and second is the to show just that vector field function is solenoidal. Now the third problem is that we have to show that the vector field that is defined by vector f is equal to x square plus x y square I plus y square plus x square y j is irrotational. So this problem is related to the curl operator, and I have to find out first of all that value of the curl that defined by the cross product of these two, then goes f. So this is known as curl of this vector field function f. The curl operator always operates only on the vector field function. Divergence and curl operator operates always on the vector field function. So this curl, which is defined mathematically by this cross product, so del cross f is the curl of f that can be defined in terms of the determinant that can be written as iota in the first row, I, j, k, these are the unit vector, and now the differential term del upon del x, del upon del y, del upon del z, and the component of the vector field, so fx, fy, and this is fz. So if you see this vector f, which is defined in terms of I, j, and k, so there is no term of k. So this is known as fx, this is fy, and there is no term of k, so that fz is equal to 0. So in this numerical problem, fz is equal to 0. This is the first point. So here in this question, we have to show that this vector field function is irrotational. What is the meaning of irrotational? When we measure the curl of any vector field function, that means we measure the rate of rotation of that field. Curl in the vector field lines, we measure that basically. So the result of this curl will be a vector quantity. It means there will be magnitude, there will be direction. So right now we have to show that vector field function, this vector f, is irrotational. Irrotational means there is no curl. That means this del cross f is equal to 0. If this vector field function satisfy this particular condition, which is del cross f is equal to 0, the vector field function will be irrotational. So in curl we use the scientific word irrotational. In the divergence we use the word solenoidal. So irrotational means there is no curl of the vector. Now I have to put the value of fx, fy, and fz. Here fx is given, fy is given, but fz is equal to 0. So by putting the value of this field component here, fx, that is x square plus xy square, fy is equal to y square plus x square y. So I have to put these values. But before that, I have to expand this determinant with respect to I, j, and k. So this is x square plus xy square. So with the expansion of curl F with respect to ijk, the first term I, and I have this del fz upon del y minus del fy upon del z, then minus j. Minus j is this one. I have to use this one and this particular. So del upon del x and that fz minus this term minus del fx upon del z and then k plus k, and now that result will be this one del upon del x fy minus del fx upon del y. So this is the expansion of this determinant with respect to I, j and k. So first of all, we have to write that curl in terms of the determinant. There we have to put the value of fx, fy, fz. These are the field component along the x, y and z directions. So now fx is equal to x square plus xy square, fy is equal to y square plus x square y. So the result is fz is 0. So this term will be equal to 0. This term is equal to 0 because there is no term of fz here. Fy is this one and there is only y, x, x and y variable, and it is differentiating with respect to z. So again its result will be equal to 0. What is the point? Point is that this fy have only two variables, x and y, these two variables. And we are differentiating this one with respect to z. So because of this, this result will be equal to 0. So it means there is no component of I. Now the second term, j. Del fz is differentiating with fx, x, but there is no term of fz. So this term is equal to 0. And this fx is differentiating with respect to z. Here fx is defined by only two variables, they are x and y. So again this term is equal to 0. Now for the k component, del fy is differentiating with respect to x. This is our del fy, this is our fy, which are two variables x and y. We have to differentiate it with respect to x. So when I differentiate this with respect to x, the result will be for this is equal to 0, and for this will be 2xy. And now for this fx is differentiating with respect to y. So this fx is function of again two variables, they are x and y. So now I am differentiating this with respect to y. This function I am differentiating with respect to y. So function is x square plus xy square. And the result is for the first 0, and in this case this is 2xy. Now I am putting these two values here in this. Del fy upon del x is equal to 2xy minus del fx upon del y, again same, that is 2xy. So this is equal to 0. It means all the components of unit vectors I, that is 0, g 0, 0. So the result is 0. It means the curl of this vector field satisfies the condition of the field is irrotational. So del cross F is equal to 0. It means the field will be irrotational. It means there is no rotation of the field. So such kind of field is known as irrotational field. When the curl of any vector field is equal to 0, then we say the field is irrotational.